Hello student, today we are going to learn what is the first law of thermodynamics and its limitation. First, what is first law of thermodynamics? Statement 1. For first law of thermodynamics, heat and mechanical work are mutually convertible. That means, according to this law, when a closed system undergoes a thermodynamic cycle, the net heat transfer is equal to the net work transfer. Okay. A definite amount of mechanical work is needed to produce a definite nirdishto amount of heat and vice versa. Okay, so H equal to W by J, where capital H equal to amount of heat, capital W equal to the amount of mechanical work, and J equal to mechanical equivalent of heat. Okay. Now, second statement, statement 2, for first law of thermodynamics, the energy can neither be created nor destroyed, cannot create nor destroy it, though it can be transform from one form to another. Okay, this statement is also called law of conservation of energy. According to this law, when a system undergoes a change of state or a thermodynamic process, then both heat transfer and work transfer take place. In all transformation, the energy due to heat unit supplied must be balanced by external work done plus the gain in internal energy due to rise of temperature. Okay, so dH equal to du plus dW, where dH equal to heat transfer, du equal to change in internal energy, that is mCv dt, mass and specific heat at constant volume, and change of temperature. dW equal to work done, that is integration of P into dV. Okay. Now, what is the limitation of first law of thermodynamics? Number one, this law does not specify the direction of flow of heat and work, not specify direction whether the heat flow from a hot body to a cold body or from a cold body to hot body. It also does not give any condition under which this transfer takes place. Okay. Second limitation, there is limitation on the conversion of one form of energy to another form, but provide no information regarding feasibility of such transformation. Okay. While mechanical work can be fully converted into heat energy, but only a part of heat energy converted into mechanical energy. Heat energy cannot be fully converted into mechanical energy. Hence, the conception of mutual convertibility of heat and a mechanical work is not fully true. Okay. For example, bags in car, bags are applied to stop a car. Kinetic energy is converted into heat energy. Okay. The same heat energy cannot be used to start the car for running. Okay. It is clear, my student? Thank you.